Can you possibly imagine an era when gigantic-sized arthropods roamed and ruled the Earth? You don't have to imagine that hard. Meet Arthropleura, the largest known invertebrate to have lived on land. Growing to such gigantic size and amassing such tremendous weight, it is perhaps a blessing that it has gone into extinction. Several fossils of this creepy behemoth have been found in several parts of the world. However, there has never been any complete fossil. As a result of this, there are several things and aspects of this historic arthropod which scientists and researchers have had to make educated guesses about. Even if you hate any of such creepy crawling animals, you certainly will be fascinated with this particular piece of nature. Simply watch the documentary to the end, and you'll be surprised by the features of this prehistoric invertebrate. How it became that big is particularly an interesting thing. Arthropleura was first discovered in 1854 by Jordan and Meyer. Its name, Arthropleura, is a Greek word which literally means jointed ribs. It is an ancient ancestor of modern-day millipedes and centipedes. It is believed to be most closely related to modern-day Penicillata, which is a group of arthropods that includes several tiny bristle millipedes, polyxenus, which are predominantly found in dry habitats of the eastern parts of North America. Arthropleura can easily be identified by its long, segmented body, which is composed of two large pinchers and two antennae located on the head region. Each segment of the body is made up of three armor plates, in which one is on the back, and one other on each side, serving as a protective layer. It, however, had a soft underbelly. There are several legs underneath the armor plates, but there also exists a pair of legs on each side of the lengthy body. They can be identified by their distinctively red-colored body, which have yellow lines, while others are brown-hued with equally yellow lines. The name jointed ribs is particularly descriptive of this arthropod because it has a very long body that is composed of as many as 30 jointed segments. Given these numerous jointed segments, an Arthropleura is estimated to have measured between 8 to 10 feet, about 2.5 to 3 meters long. In fact, some researchers believe that there might have been larger specimens since no complete fossil has ever been discovered. To make matters worse, it has been estimated by some researchers that it might have weighed as much as 500 kilograms. That's about 1,100 pounds. You certainly would not want to encounter one of these or trip over one while walking through the woods if you happen to reside where it used to live. Millions of years ago, there existed a supercontinent called Laurasia. Due to several factors, and particularly the shift in tectonic plates, this continent broke into two, giving us what we call Europe and North America. That's where Arthropleura lived. As a result, Arthropleura lived in Europe and North America, especially in areas such as Scotland, Germany, North America, and northeastern part of the US, where several fossils have been discovered. It lived about 345 to 295 million years ago. The presence of this higher oxygen ratio in the atmosphere was what made these arthropods to get so big and long. The Carboniferous was also a period so named because it was the time when the great deposit of Earth's coal, which powered the Industrial Revolution, was formed. It happens that during this time, when trees fall, there weren't many organisms to cause it to decay as it would today. Instead, such trees would become buried in swamps as the earth was much wetter then. It is due to intense heat and pressure from this constantly piling up buried trees, which form the energy producing coal, which we continue to enjoy till today. Researchers are still not sure about the diet of Arthropleura. While earlier research suggests that Arthropleura might have been an omnivore or a carnivore, more recent research affirms that they must have been herbivores and didn't hunt other animals. Otto Cross, a German researcher and expert on present-day millipedes, studied the contents of the gut of a sample discovered in Scotland and was convinced that Arthropleuras were herbivores. The contents of the sample's gut contained fossils of ancient fern-like plants and fossilized pollens. Some other researchers believe that juvenile Arthropleura might have been a carnivore, learning to digest plant matter and switching to a herbivorous diet only upon attainment of adulthood. The reason why there are divergent opinions with regard to its diet is that there have never been found fossils of its mouth part. This is also why many believe it was a herbivore, since non-fossilization of its mouth suggests that the mouth was made of soft matter, which wouldn't have been the case for a carnivorous animal. Arthropleura is therefore thought to be one of the first herbivorous animals to have ever walked the earth. But, as mentioned, it's still possible that Arthropleura was carnivorous. Given the Carboniferous period in which it existed, its armor plates, which are surprisingly thinner than expected, its lengthy size, venomous stingers, and a relatively aggressive attitude, the Arthropleura is believed to have had no natural predators, not even humans. Though Arthropleura shared its environment with other large animals such as Meganeura, which had wings longer than 2 feet, 60 centimeters, it nonetheless had nothing to fear, as no other animal would dare prey on it. Though it was completely blind, it did, however, have a good sense of smell and touch through the use of its antenna. While some researchers believe that it also had a thin, long, metallic-looking tube located behind its mandibles through which it can inject venom, some other researchers argue that it may have been non-venomous. From the research of Otto Krauss and an expert in ancient arthropods, Karsten Brockmann, they believe that the armor of the Arthropleura is relatively thin, which is partly why they believe this arthropod had nothing to fear. It even had a soft underbelly which would often expose when it rears itself up in response to an intrusion or challenge. It is unfortunate that it became extinct about 290 million years ago. It probably became extinct due to climatic change, as the Earth became drier and hotter than its preferred cool, wet habitat. Since it lived long before the dinosaurs, there is no, and never will be, a record of Arthropleura attacking a human being. Hypothetically speaking, however, assuming it was still alive, Arthropleura could have attacked and even caused the death of a human being given its large, sharp pincers and the possibility of being venomous, as suggested by some researchers. Noted for being aggressive, it would have easily stood taller than any human. But if it was an herbivore, you could have been safe by simply keeping distance and not disturbing it. However, if it really was carnivorous, it would have been a great threat for humans. A look back into Earth's 4.5 billion years history would leave us amazed at the kinds of phenomenal creatures that once lived and ruled the Earth. Till today, while we still keep fantasizing about dinosaurs, there are other bewilderingly gigantic and unusual animals such as this arthropod, the Arthropleura we have just examined. The world is indeed full of present and lost wonders which we are determined to uncover. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe,